Some major breaking news just into CNN. A source telling CNN the Vice President of the United States, Kamala Harris, has tested positive for COVID-19. Let's get straight to our White House correspondent, Arlette Sines. Arlette, what do we know?
Well, John, Vice President Kamala Harris has tested positive for COVID-19. A source familiar with that told our colleague Jasmine Wright. And then just a short while ago, the press secretary for Vice President Harris also put out a statement that she tested positive for COVID-19 on a rapid and PCR test today. Now, it's important to note that she has not been a close contact of President Biden because she has actually been traveling for the past week. Vice President Harris had been spending some time in California. She flew back yesterday, and she had been slated to participate in a classified briefing, receiving the president's daily brief with the president this morning at 10:15. But according to her office, she has not been a close contact of the president due to their travel schedules. Now, the press secretary, Kirsten Allen, for Vice President Harris, said that Harris has exhibited no symptoms. She will isolate and continue to work from the vice president's residence, and she will follow the CDC guidelines and the advice of her physicians, and she will return to the White House once she tests negative. But at this moment, the vice president has tested positive for COVID-19. She is the highest ranking administration official within the Biden administration to do so. You'll remember a few months ago, her husband, second gentleman Doug Emhoff, had also tested positive for COVID-19. But now we have learned that Vice President Harris does have COVID-19.
Arlette Sines, appreciate the hustle on the breaking news. Let's bring the conversation back into the room. On the one hand, this is part of our life now.
Right.
It's part of our life. We've seen after, as people resume their travels, we saw our big recent dinners here in Washington, D.C., you see this happen. But to have it happen to the Vice President of the United States, who is vaccinated, who is boosted, but who is in proximity, not recently to the President of the United States, but to people of power all the time, plus out on the road.
Yeah, and you have seen the White House kind of lay the groundwork for this. As you said, there have been a number of positive tests around the president, around the White House. And you saw the White House a few weeks ago essentially said, listen, the president himself is going to go about living his life. Essentially, he may get COVID, but listen, he is vaccinated and boosted. And so now you have the vice president in a similar situation. Not a surprise in some ways because of what we know about this recent variant, because also they're sort of opening back up in terms of being on the road, not wearing masks in the way that they were months and months ago. And so it's no surprise. We, of course, wish her the best and a speedy recovery.
And no symptoms. I'm going to take the precautions. Again, part of your life. But it still knocks you back a little bit when you see it moving high up levels of power.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, I think for all of us, you know, hopefully, as we've noted, the vice president vaccinated, boosted. It's unlikely that this is going to be a threat to her life, especially if she's asymptomatic. Assuming that's how it plays out, I mean, the question is always the president of the United States. He's an older person who is at more risk of significant side effects from COVID. And if you think about the political environment and how this has all become, you know, whether you wear a mask or not is kind of like waving a red or a blue flag, right? Which team are you on? And that's a real problem when you're just trying to protect yourself or make a decision about, hey, I'm more vulnerable than you are. I maybe need to wear a mask. It's fine with me if you don't. You know, they have to make all of these kinds of decisions in a much different environment.
And the timing matters in this case because the vice president is not a close contact to the president or the first lady because she's been out on the road. But it reminds you, number one, president, vice president always have jobs to do that include travel. But we're in the middle. It's just heating up in a midterm election campaign where, yes, COVID is not what it was 6 months ago or certainly a year ago, but it is still with us when you have, whether it's the president, the vice president, incumbent members of Congress and senators all out there again now in these group settings.
Yeah, look, the White House has changed their posture. I mean, we've all kind of covered the White House. They all have their own rhythms. They have their own patterns. This White House has gone to, I don't want to say a COVID doesn't exist pattern, because that's not the right way to say it. But they're living their lives in a more open way. You see the president on the road. You see the vice president on the road. You just saw the president out doing his first on-the-road fundraisers out in Portland.
He's supposed to come to the White House Correspondents' Dinner.
Mm-hmm. That's a great point, right? They are going through the motions. And we can take a poll and a survey, and if we're all on camera at the White House Correspondents' Dinner, but I suspect a lot of us aren't going to have our masks on. And they'll be able to see Casey and I when we tell jokes to each other and smile and laugh at jokes that we shouldn't laugh. But to be serious about it, the White House has a plan for this. They're prepared for it. And look at how smooth the communication rollout has been that the Vice President of the United States has just tested. They got all the information out very quickly. I would be shocked if there were not a communications plan on the shelf that they can dust off if and when, and let's just say, let's hope it's if, and that the president doesn't get COVID. But if the president should get COVID, they will have a routine rote plan to go to that they can assure the American people who he's talked to, how his health is, and where to go from there.